It was, you know, the intangibles, the honesty, the integrity, the character, which I don't think is focused on enough nowadays.
What we can do is see somebody, know they're not perfect, none of us are, but are willing to accept certain things. And for example, you might know somebody in the beginning and think, you know, I'm not too keen on that. It's like the red flag thing. I'm not too keen on that, but I can work with it. Whereas I think by nature, men tend to be more, whether this is negative or positive, practical and black and white, tend not to blur things. So they tend to see what's there in front of them. That's not bad. Actually, sometimes that can be quite good. This is the situation. Can I deal with it? Yes or no, rather than maybe let me give it a try anyway. And I think that's where there's some kind of disconnect sometimes. Women tend to be like, oh, I'm going to ignore that. I'm going to go through, follow with the heart. Men, a lot of the time, obviously this is a blanket before the feminist army come for me.
yeah, don't get Dave Chappelle.
I like being cancelled. Anyway, no, but tend to see a true picture of what it is without romanticising. I think I've been guilty of that in the past as well. Like, yeah. Oh, that's all right. When actually, no, that's not all right. And that's, you know, probably move on.
So, Uncle Rods, what's your take on this?
I think both points that Dan and Cara made absolutely are valid. But my take on this is much wider, and it is more to do with the fact that if we think how men and women were attracted today versus 100 years versus 200 years ago, we would all agree that we see differences. We see differences for very real reasons. Our parents, my parents, they only could check the people in their little town where they came from. They didn't go from country to country. And it leads me to the point that today's generation, younger generation, have the benefit. I say benefit is both a curse and a benefit of choice.
Mm.
You can
options.
Socially, you can check whoever you want, right? Mm. You can go virtually wherever you want. And by virtue of this little bugger, you can have contact with anybody you want. Now, choice is not necessarily always a good thing. I'm just going to talk about men for a second. Men can look at a woman and say, I don't like this about her, so I'm going to swipe her. I don't know where it's left or right because I've never been on it, but I know you swipe one way, right? So it's virtue of the mobile phone. We have the option to swipe left or right, whether we like a look of a woman or don't like a woman, don't like the look of her. So we are now got down to a stage where we don't know her. We don't know what she sounds like. We don't know what her morals are. Maybe they don't even care, but purely just on her looks. So we have that to contend with. And this is not just about men. I'm sure women do the same thing. But we're also coming to an age where women's rights have come to the forefront, and rightly so. But that also has brought its problems. We now have, and we talked about it previously, when women now want to be the same as men. Now, we know we ain't exactly the same. We're never going to be the same. But that has brought problems. Now, does that bring contention between men and women? Of course it does. So you put it all in this mix, right? We've got technological advances. We've got massive social change. We've got massive opportunities for both sexes, right? Of course, there's going to now be this real juxtaposition as to a good man versus a good woman. We've made it much, much harder for ourselves. Everybody, as I call it, the instant generation, both men and women, I want success. Success means I can't get married, I can't get hitched before I've done this, I've done that, I've got the car, I've got the house, I've done that. Whereas obviously generations before, you never expected that to do it by yourself. You expected, let me find my life partner and we build together. So there are some real social reasons why finding a partner now is much harder. And it's not because there's no good man or there's no good woman. Definitely not, in my humble opinion.
Yeah, we've seen,
absolutely agree.
Something I've said to Ryan before is like, The relationship is a two-player sport.
Absolutely.
And I feel like actually, you know, you've touched on it a bit just now. The whole idea of success is sometimes looking at it from a very individual lens, you know. There's some men that probably don't want to, you know, date a woman unless they're set up in the right way. And there's probably some women out there who probably said, you know what, I've got to have X, Y, and Z before I even meet a man. And actually, because I've achieved that, I can't even be speaking to a man who hasn't got those things. So I feel like now the caliber of partner is now linked to, unfortunately, like material things. And actually that has nothing to do with, like you said, someone's integrity, you know, what their morals are like, none of those things. Like I said, I don't think that all of a sudden all the good men have got married and actually what's left is just the scraps. And the same thing I don't think for the women. I don't think the women have just all got married off and now there's this random women left. Like, I just don't think that's the case. I think what people are looking for, you know, it's actually right in front of them. My thing, I've always said it to a lot of people, I think their perfect partner, okay, I'll take perfect partner away because a lot of people don't like that phrase. I feel like the right person for you, more time than not, is actually right in front of you. I feel like they're a close proximity away. They could even be disguised as a friend, you know, but we're not looking at that because they're thinking they're a friend and therefore, no, it's just never going to work. Actually, you know, I reckon that for those who do keep, you know, decent friends of the opposite sex, I think you'd find probably they even might have most of the qualities that you'd probably, you know, I think that I'm not saying it's 100% truth, but my thing is that everyone feels like there is a perfect version of the right person out there. And actually, you know, there's something out there which is for you. And it's actually, I don't think it's that far away from you. This whole concept that is so far away and that there's none left. It feels strange to say that.
It comes back to what Uncle Rodney was saying about choice. It's like, I compare it to, you know, when you go to a restaurant and there's so much on the menu, you don't even know where to start.
Yeah.
You'll go to a Chinese restaurant and they serve Malaysian, Thai, everything. And you're just like, you know what? Let's go somewhere else because this is just too much. Yeah. And you cannot choose. And I go back to when, and it wasn't that long ago, when me and my missus started talking. My thing was, we didn't have access to millions of girls and whatnot. So my thing was, let me rob the bank and get out of there straight away. As soon as I saw something that was decent, she might not tick every single box that I had in my head, but I thought, you know what? She ticked the boxes, the most important boxes for me.
Yeah.
And it wasn't, although my missus I believe is a beautiful woman, it wasn't that initially. It was, you know, the intangibles, the honesty, the integrity, the character, which I don't think is focused on enough nowadays. Mm-hmm. Everyone has got this picture in their head of, I need someone who's this. I need him to be 6'4" with a six pack and drives this. And before they even get to the other part. So how many people even get through that first stage to even show what kind of person they are? Not many, because they don't pass the first test.
They're not getting there.
Nobody's getting there.
Stuart touched on it, right? It is, it's not only things like what have you material you've got to bring. I know people who say they're not checking nobody if they ain't got a degree. Now, not if they haven't got a good job, right? They say, because I am a graduate, because I've got a master's, I want somebody of equal status. So my point of view was, so does that mean with somebody without a degree hasn't got the intelligence, right? But that was their stance. That was clearly their stance. So again, it comes down to people, they're almost trying to make a menu of what a perfect partner is.
There's no such thing.
I totally agree. Why did I say opposites attract? If that was the case, nobody in their right mind would ever say, I want somebody who's totally opposite to me in X, Y, Z, right? That just wouldn't work. But that's not the way human beings operate.
What I would say, though, just quickly, whilst I think to me that's wild, and possibly by the way you said it to you, that's like kind of off the wall comment to make. I think it's good that people are open about these things, because too much of what happens is people don't state their non-negotiables, or they don't stick to them at the beginning, and then later on down the line that becomes a sticking point. To me, also, with that situation, whether I had a degree or not, I would find that line of thinking slightly odd and probably would want to even stay away from somebody like that.
That is a red flag in itself.
Yeah, exactly. So to me, whilst it's not my, it wouldn't be, I would find that odd. I'm glad that people are able to be that honest about certain things, whether it's about not having a degree, whether it's about only dating people from, you know, certain, you know, socioeconomic group, or only people who have a certain job or earning a certain type of money. Make these things clear, because then I can cut.